I was looking at Home Depot at these small water heaters. This is only a 30-gallon water heater. And it's kind of interesting because it has, you can see it has two access ports, and it actually has two elements. They're both 4,500-watt, 240-volt elements, which is the normal hot water heater element that I use on the water heater controller. And it would work really good for someone that wants to go off-grid or someone that wants to preheat a gas water heater. So I just thought I'd show that. And here's the solar hybrid hot water controller. And if you didn't see the previous videos, you might want to go on my channel and see how it's normally supposed to be hooked up. Normally, you would just hook it up to the lower element. And in this case, it's kind of a different setup, and it's more of an off-grid setup because I'm hooked directly to the water tank with this plug that I added. So what happens is the solar comes in on this orange wire, and it goes out down to the plug, which goes to my normal water heater. And it's hooked up normally. There's the top. And what happens is this upper element comes on first. On a normal water heater, and this nothing has changed. I don't change out the elements. This is the same element that came from the store. And it's 4,500-watt, 240 volts, but we're running it off of solar. And the controller takes care of all the differences. So here you've got the upper element, and it comes on first, and it heats the top of the tank first. And then once that's heated up, then the lower element comes on. And all this wire is, this is just my little sensor wire, my temperature sensor wire that I hooked up for monitoring. And so now I have the option, and this is just a dryer plug for an electric dryer, and you can buy these at Home Depot. And now I have the option of either plugging it into the grid, or I can plug it in and be off grid. Right now, at summertime, I'm pushing about 300 watts into this with my panels configured that way. I have 12-volt panels, so I can configure them any way I want. And I've only got 300 watts coming in, and it's working out really well. The top of the tank stays warm all the time, stays hot. And so you're only got, you know, it's probably about 20 gallons here. So it's kind of like that 30-gallon tank. It's 20 gallons of hot water, and, you know, if only half is heated. And then once this is heated up, then obviously the lower comes on. But at 300 watts, it seems to keep it pretty warm. And you only use, you know, 20 gallons is quite a bit for taking a shower because you only use a little bit of that because you're using cold water. You don't use 100% hot water when you take a shower. So that's what you're looking at, is it's completely off-grid. And it's summertime, so there's a lot less loss for the tank, for the outside of the tank has a lot less loss. And there's the solar hybrid hot water controller. You see it blinking away. And one of the things that you got to understand with this box, this is a Home Depot box you buy. It's an Eaton box. It's only $7. And when you buy this box, you're not paying any extra shipping. And you're probably going to go to Home Depot and you're going to buy this backing board. You're going to buy some wire. You're going to buy the socket. Maybe you're going to buy the plug. I don't know. But so while you're there, buy the box. And it saves you a lot of money. And it's pretty simple to mount. There's only a few holes you have to drill. And then you get this really nifty disconnect. And it's got four terminals, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it helps you wire everything up. So for $7, you can't beat this, basically. And that's what you're looking at. And of course, the board here and all that is available on eBay. And that's the solar hybrid hot water controller. Thanks for watching.